August it's for free.
Yeah, on YouTube. And hey, let me ask you a question.
You bet.
I have one for free movie. Oops, wrong one. Let me see. This one. There you go. Four free movies. It's 180 the movie, Evolution versus God, Noah, and Genius the movie. And it's for free online just for you, my dear.
Love it! All right.
So let me ask you a question.
Yep.
Now, if you died today, would you go to heaven or hell?
Well, I'm a Buddhist, so I don't believe that I would go to either.
Well, what do you think? Even if you're a Buddhist, despite if we believe it's there or not, does it change the fact that it is there, you know? So,
well, yeah, no. Me, I don't believe there's a heaven and a hell. I believe
right.
There's reincarnation. So that's my deal.
Right.
So I don't, you know, how can I say I would go to one or the other when I don't believe personally, but I do believe that the soul lives on and that good deeds are rewarded and that bad deeds are not.
Right.
So, yeah.
So let's think about this. Now, do you consider yourself a good person?
Oh, without a doubt.
Without a doubt. Okay, yeah. Well, that's good to know.
Yeah.
Now, but can I ask you a question? Can we test and see if you are a good person?
Okay.
Now, how many lies have you told in your entire life?
About a million and a half.
I'm guilty myself.
Yes.
And thank you for being honest. Now, what do you call someone who tells a lie?
You have no value.
Well, generally a liar.
That's true. It is.
That
is true.
Yeah.
And now, have you ever stolen anything in your entire life? And it's taken something that isn't yours.
Absolutely.
Okay, good. I didn't have to define it for you.
No, absolutely. Okay.
All right, now what do you call someone who steals?
A thief.
A thief, that's right. Now, have you ever took God's name in vain and used it as a cuss word?
Absolutely.
And you know, that is called blasphemy.
Right.
God takes that very seriously.
Right.
It's interesting, I think about it, and so you don't believe there is a God, correct?
Oh no, I believe there's a God. Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, you believe there's a creator then?
I believe there's a creator.
Oh,
yep.
Okay.
Yep.
Oh, all right.
Totally do.
And all Buddhists believe that?
Oh yeah, we absolutely believe, but it's more that it's instead of a person, like a deity, it's more of a universal God, if you will. Yeah.
All right. Now, so isn't it interesting when people usually cuss or take a name in vain, you never hear someone say, oh Buddha, or oh
right.
Muhammad.
Right.
They say, oh God, and it's really sad. You know, you even see them take the Son of God's name as a cuss word. But we never, all these other religions definitely have Joseph Smith, and...
Right.
It's interesting to say that.
That is interesting.
Right. I never thought about that.
I never thought about that before.
So right now, you admitted, and this is only three of the, a lying thief and a blasphemer at heart.
Sure.
And there's like seven other laws, but
right.
To make it quick, I'll just do three. Now, based on these three laws that you have broken, if you were judged on these laws, would you be considered innocent or guilty of breaking these laws?
Oh, I'm guilty of breaking those laws.
Yeah. Myself included.
But I don't think that changes whether I'm a good person or not.
No, it shows us that, you know, we can always look around this world and we can always find someone better than us or worse than us. My kids do that a lot.
Right.
Well, I'm not as bad as that person.
Right.
I'm not as bad as that person.
Right.
But ultimately, we aren't perfect, right? And the opposite of that is we're not really good. We fall short.
Absolutely.
We all fall short, and we're not perfection, or we wouldn't look at our skin and
judge ourselves as much as others.
And so anyways, now let's say we die today, and despite our own beliefs, that we come before God.
Right.
And we are judged based on the Ten Commandments. Now, based on the Ten Commandments, would we go to heaven or hell based on the Ten Commandments? Despite our beliefs, would we?
I'd go to heaven.
You think you'd go to heaven?
Without a doubt.
Okay. Now, you know, if we got judged from a law based on the Ten Commandments, and we went to the San Diego judge, and knowing he has a standard to follow by
law. That's right.
And he can't compromise that, correct?
Right.
All right. Well, God being even having a higher authority,
right?
And even being perfect without blemish,
right?
His standards are way higher.
Absolutely.
So he can't compromise.
Right.
He can't lie, so he has that's not the law.
Right.
But so just to show that his standards are higher than the judge.
Yes.
Do you agree?
Well, yes, but the judge has, and he has a lot more, there's grades, there's degrees. So just like in the law, the judicial law, there are degrees.
Right.
If you, steal a thing of candy and you're 6, it's different than if you murder somebody.
Right.
And lie in wait.
Right.
So hence the difference, and I think there's difference in the
afterlife
as well.
But showing even in that 6-year-old,
right,
we're coming out with rebellion from the beginning.
Right.
And it could progress if he doesn't identify this issue of rebellion in all of us,
pretty much.
Because we're prone to rebel.
Oh, absolutely.
Right.
Yeah.
So that's why I'm saying, even though a judge has high standards, God has a higher standard.
Right.
So now that we got that cleared, so if we got judged on the Ten Commandments,
right,
this is all we're looking at.
Right.
Would we go to heaven or hell?
I still think I'd go to heaven.
Yeah. But you have to be perfect. No way. The Bible states that you have to be perfect to enter heaven. So technically, all of us would go to hell.
Exactly. Okay.
Right? So if you die today in your sin, lying, stealing, committing adultery or coveting, we would go to hell. Do you agree?
If that was the standard,
right.
Perfection were the standard, then absolutely.
Where would we go?
Hell.
Okay, hell. Now, would that concern you if you went to hell?
Hell yes.
Yes. It concerned me too.
Yes.
And you know what? That was the bad news.
Right.
And I started studying, and I saw that we all have sin. And it's evident by us looking at people, we have a fallen nation, a fallen people. And I'm like, we all have sin. But guess what? That God loved us so much that he sent his son Jesus Christ to come and die on the cross for our sins. He paid that penalty. His blood was shed on the cross and paid that penalty of sin. But we have the wages of sin is death, and the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. But it's a free gift. So, for instance, like that judge that I was telling you about, he says, for your penalty, you committed a crime. And this crime, you have to pay $500,000.
Right.
Or you go to prison for life.
Right.
We don't have that money to pay, so where are we headed?
Right.
Life in prison.
Right.
But guess what? This judge takes off his coat and comes to you, the judge, and hands you the $500,000.
He says you're off.
And says you're spot free. But the thing is, how can you exclude that fine? What do you have to do? The judge has something in his hand, the money, the $500,000.
Right.
So what do you have to do to get free?
Oh, you have to believe that he has it.
And you have to take it from him, right?
You have to take it from him, right?
That's right.
Right, right.
And see, that's what Jesus did for you. He did that for you, but you have to take it, embrace it, and
right.
said, I believe. See, we all know lying's wrong. We all know stealing's wrong because it was instilled in him, in us.
Right.
And it was written in our hearts. God placed those laws in our hearts. So we know that lying's wrong.
Right.
And so it's not, this is something that God has placed from birth. And so the Word of God is there for us to embrace it and read it and know that God is real, that Jesus Christ is the only way, the truth, and the life. And I encourage you to really settle your salvation, because it's available to you only if you grab it. And you repent, turn from your sins, and trust in Jesus. Turn from your sins and trust in Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ saved us from eternal damnation 2,000 years ago. Jesus was the hero of his movie when he walked upon this earth to bring victory to how many who would come and call upon the name of the Lord. The salvation is free and it's near to those who would call upon him.